morning, my dear students. I am Farha Bano. I welcome you all in my class. How are you all? I hope you all are fine at your home. My dear students, today we are going to start our new lesson, lesson 5. Just imagine. In this lesson, we will study about imagination. As you know, being imaginative makes you more creative. Now, look at your screen. Ponder is given. Now start reading Ponder. We all love to imagine and daydream about things, place and people. Imagine yourself to be an ant. Draw things around you from your perspective. Here, students, you have to draw things which are around you, which you like, and you have to draw after imagination. I hope you all will try at your home. Now, the next thing also shown on your screen, did you know? Here, being imaginative makes you more creative and helps in problem solving skills. Being imaginative keeps the brain active and healthy. Now let's start our lesson, lesson 5, just imagine. First, you can see this lesson is written by the poet Santhini Govindan. Santhini Govindan is a widely published award-winning author of children's literature in English. She has written more than 50 books, including poetry, picture books and short stories for children of all ages. She is a good dog lover and art enthusiast whose hobbies include collecting bell. Now, this is all about the poet Santhini Govindan. She is widely published award-winning author of children's literature. She is also a dog lover. She has written more than 50 books, including poetry, picture books and short story for all ages of four children. Now let's start our lesson, lesson 5, just imagine. Just imagine, if crocodiles had to brush their teeth, the way I do every morning and night. Just imagine the number of toothbrushes they would need to keep all those rows of teeth sparkling white. Here, my dear students, poet want to say, you just imagine if crocodile had to brush their teeth. The way I do means the way we do brush to our teeth every morning and night. Like that, if crocodile had to brush their teeth the way I do every morning and night. Just imagine the number of toothbrushes they would need to keep all those rows of teeth sparkling white. Then just imagine the number of toothbrushes they would need, because the teeth, there are so many rows of teeth of crocodile. That's why they would need so many toothbrush to clean their teeth. That is why we want to say here, if crocodile had to brush their teeth the way I do every morning and night, just imagine the number of toothbrushes they would need to keep all those rows of teeth sparkling white. Here the meaning of sparkling is shining. Now the second stanza. If elephants had to use handkerchiefs every time they sneezed or had a bad cold, just imagine how many hankies they would have to wash and iron and fold. Now the first stanza is all about crocodile. Now the second stanza is for an elephant. Here the poet says, just imagine if elephant had to use handkerchiefs every time they sneezed, means sometimes you are feeling cold, cough and cold, then you are suffering from sneeze. If elephant have to use handkerchief every time they sneezed or had a bad cold, just imagine how many hankies they would have. Just imagine how many hankies they would have to use every now and then, as they are suffering from bad cold. Just imagine how many hankies they would have to wash, to iron and to fold. To wash, to iron and to fold. Just imagine if elephant had to use handkerchiefs every time they sneezed or had a bad cold. Just imagine how many hankies they would have to wash and iron and fold. This is the first part of your lesson 5, just imagine. In the next video, we will continue the poem. Now it's time for your homework. Your homework is learn and write 8 lines of the poem Just Imagine. This is your homework. I hope you will do your homework at your home. Thank you so much. God bless you.